Hi guys, thank you, Alejandro. About Interstellar, I love that movie because I like fiction, science fiction teacher. How do you say?
Science
fiction. Yep. And I love topics about time machine or time travelers. So I love this movie for that. Also because I love its music. It is amazing for me. And I love all about stars and galaxies, etc. So I like also Dark, for example, about traveling. And things like that. Another thing about the movie Interstellar, I love the relationship between Cooper and his daughter. I find very dramatic the separation between them. And that's all. I love Interstellar. It's my favorite movie.
Oh, okay, it's very interesting.
Okay. Anyone want to say something about your favorite movie or series, Alina or Mario Paz?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay, the movie is Pride and Prejudice. It's about this book. You seen? Yes.
Yes. Wow, you even have the book.
Yes, I love it. It's my favorite book and my favorite movie. This movie at the time which the film is based it was very important to get married in this, how can I say, época?
It begins in this time.
Sorry, teacher?
You can say in back in that time.
In back?
No, back in that time.
Back in that time.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, it's very important to get married. But Elizabeth, the protagonist, will only marry for true love. And when he meets Darcy, he starts to judge him with him, with having met him. No, how can I say? No, she judged him is who's God, right?
Yeah, judge.
And is it so cruel and cold, but he's not like this. She's sweet, she's rich, but Elizabeth, well, that's the how can I say,
like the plot.
Sorry, excuse me?
That's the plot.
The plot, with the precious, the pride, all the Elizabeth and Darcy. So it's my favorite movie because he's so funny in that situation and love, and I love that kind of types to movie, and yes, that's all.
Thanks, Mari Paz. And Alina?
Okay, Breaking Bad is my favorite because, for me, it's really strong series, but it's not, how do you say, alejada?
It's not far away.
Not far off the reality. Because I think the drugs destroy life in general. The power change life. How do you say destroy for
like ruin?
Yes, yes, yes. And my favorite movie is Untouchables.
Untouchable.
Sí.
No, it, but
untouchable.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Because the protagonist have too much money and he don't has health and the message of the movie is the importance of the reality friends. Mm-hmm. It's, for me, it's the message for this movie.
Yes, I like this movie too. Okay, Danny or Andrea?
I love movie Price Prejudice, but I don't like it. I feel it's weird because I feel incomplete, but I want more the movie, but I love how you say casting.
How do you what?
Casi, casi toda la película.
Oh, almost.
I love almost movie, but the end is weird. But for me, it's very incomplete. It's weird, but I love the Price and Prejudice. And then my favorite series is Modern Family. The actor is very funny, and the how you say
episode.
My favorite episode is Tom have a customer, a cat. I clean tree for a doubter. But it's very funny. I love the Modern Family. In its general, I love.
Okay, thanks, Andrea. Well, we already have a slide for those who did not send their photo or picture, and you can almost talk and the rest. Okay, Danny? One second, please.
Hi, thank you. I think it's talk about serial movie, yes? No.
Yes.
Okay. My favorite series is Stranger Things because it's very dramatic, fantastic. It's about 90s or 18th, I don't know. This series is special for me because the soundtrack is fantastic. It's very scary and dramatic. All episodes is interesting for me. My favorite episode is when the actor, I don't know the name, I forget. the actor sing with your loved, your girlfriend, your future girlfriend, sing in the moment of, how do you say, tension?
Moment. It's the same tension.
Tension? A moment of tension, and she always sing in this moment. It's very funny for me. It's in the second session. Okay, the Train to Busan is my favorite movie. I view this movie for four times. It's very scary. I believe it's miedo, scary. Yes.
It depends on what you want to say, because it could be like it's a horror movie, like you get scared, or it's scary.
Scary. I forget this other word. Scary and horror movie. I hate the zombies. It's very horror for me. I hate the, how do you say, villano village?
The villain.
Villain, okay. The villain, I hate this villain. Is very ugh. I don't know, for I can't describe him. It's very antipathic. Is very cute. The small family in the movie. This all. Thank you.
Thank you, Dani. Ivan.
Thank you, Annabelle. About Stranger Things, there is an interesting fact in one episode. In the series, it appeared Back to the Future. The characters watch the movie Back to the Future, and that is amazing. When I saw that, I was very excited because I love Back to the Future. And about the movie Untouchable, the movie, the favorite movie, Alina's favorite movie. It is a movie that I love too, because It is about racism. How do you say racismo, teacher?
Racism.
Racism, okay. Yep. Like autism, okay. Racism, and it's about a paralytic person. And if I'm not mistaken, the story is in France. And this guy, this black guy, gets a friendship with this rich paralytic man, and it's amazing how the people can discriminate to others because their skin color, but these people who is discriminated can be, of course, great people. Is a good lesson for a lot of people. And I love one, how do you say, Sena teacher? Excuse me?
Scene.
I love one scene when the black guy dance electronic music and is in the middle of a party where it is there is a classic music band, and this guy begin to dance electronic music. It is very funny. I recommend you to watch this movie. That's all.
Okay, thanks, Ivan. Lau?
Hi, guys. I have the same opinion of Maripaz about the movie. I really like Pride and Prejudice. For me, it's incredible how in that time the girls only think about get married. The girls only think to get married. They learn how to cook, how to play a song instrument, how to make clothes or some activities only for girls. And I actually have the book too. And that movie I watched like 6 or 7 times in all my life, but I really like that movie.
Okay, thanks, Lau. Anyone want to say something about your favorite series or movie, Samantha and Alan?
Yes, I really like Umbrella Academy because I like action movies, mysteries, drama, superheroes, humor and fantasy, and she does with that.
Okay, thanks.
Well, let me see. Well, I think they like this movie because I saw this movie with this morning. We have a good time. Well, I really enjoyed this movie because a person who like things like adventure or things. Well, and the favorite part of this trip was second part and spoil it because the actors have been in a lot of places, amazing. That's fantastic. Every time my mind flew around this place because it was place is amazing. The story was very good and well, and now I like more this movie because I'm reading the first book and I think the book it's good, but the movie is that same.
Okay, thank you, Alan. Okay. Anyone want to say something about your favorite series or movie, Monse or Teacher Liz?
Thank you. I love this series and movie for this speak for the revenge. I love the revenge in the Game of Thrones. They are different family and they can the king or the queen all think merecen, what do you say, merecen?
Deserve.
Excuse me?
Deserve, like for example, you say, I deserve this car. Yes, deserve.
Deserve, okay, thank you. All things deserve the kingdom. All deserve. Thank you. nothing is bad or good. This is fight for the strong. Is very very exciting. The character Arya Stark is my favorite. She is a child, and she's training for be murderous assassin. What do you say, assassina?
Actually, both of them are kind of correct. You can say murderer or assassin.
Assassin.
Or killer. You have three words. You can say murderer, assassin, or killer.
Or killer. Okay, thank you. She's a child and training for the killer. She have a list for the people she want kill. Because they killed your family and your father. Le cortan la cabeza. What do you say?
You can say they cut his head.
The cast hit.
No, hat. Cut with T. Exactly.
Cut. They cut his hat. And she she saw this is very strong for me. And your father teach her for defenderse. And the movie La Piel Que Habito is very, very good. is the film for Almodóvar, Pedro Almodóvar, is Spanish, and this picture is very rara. What do you say?
Weird.
Rara?
Huh? Weird.
Weird.
Mm-hmm. Let me write it in the
chat. Also, speak for the revenge. El word. Thank you. The father. Search revenge mm-hmm. for this daughter. It's very crazy. He transformed a man in your wife. But
you can say the same reconstructs.
Reconstruct your mm-hmm. Oh yeah, le dijeron la palabra your body
uh-huh.
and your piel in your wife hair born in the accident
she was born
and she born in the accident because he reconstructed a man in your wife, reconstruct your body, and it's very, very weird, but it's beautiful, and trata about the revenge. I love the revenge.
That one is the one that you said, La Piel Que Habito, right, Monse?
La Piel Que Habito.
Wow, I mean, I've never watched a movie, and this is the first time that I actually hear about it. But it sounds quite interesting.
Please.
For me, is, how do you say, bizarre?
It's bizarre.
Bizarre.
Yes.
Como all the picture, all the movies de Almodóvar, all the movies are very bizarre.
Yeah, that's true.
Thank you.
Thank you, Monse.
In my case, super quick, Modern Family. I mean, I have watched lots of TV series and I usually like them. But I don't know, there's something about Modern Family that I love. First of all, I love that it's super funny. So the humor that they have, it's just crazy. So if you start watching a TV series and you actually like it, it's fun because you're going to be able to laugh at their jokes. So, and it's interesting because, for example, I don't know if you have ever heard this, but when we learn it, I mean, there are certain things that they are linked to language. For example, humor. So even if we tell a joke that in Spanish is a blast, like you hear the joke and you're laughing like crazy, in English, you might translate it and people might not laugh because of the language. There's something about it. So it happens to me that when I watch things that, like, I don't know, like stand-up comedy or anything of those things, that is, in English, it's not really funny. Like I say, like, that's kind of funny, but like, I don't laugh. It's like when we do like, so funny. That's me when I watch like funny things in English. But with Modern Family, I do laugh. Last time I was at my sister-in-law's house and I was having lunch and I was watching an episode of Modern Family and I couldn't eat because I was having a blast. I was laughing so hard at the jokes that we're saying and everything that was happening in the episode. So that's why I like it. I also like that it's super inclusive because it has like a lot of people in from different backgrounds, different types of family. That's why I like it that it's called Modern Family. And I love that at the end of every episode, they have like a model. So you watch the episode, it's super short actually. That's why I love it. It's like what, 20 minutes. And then at the end of the episode, they have like a moral. So I think that is super, super cool. It's my favorite. I mean, that's it. They have 11 seasons. I'm watching the last season and I'm loving it. And actually something weird that I have is that I don't like to watch a TV series two times. Like I only watch it once and that's it. With Modern Family, I like it so much that I'm even thinking to restart again from the first season and watch it again throughout the 11 seasons.
Thank you, teacher. Okay.
Teacher?
Yeah, tell me.
Do you like the participation of Sofia Vergara in this TV series?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. She's one of my favorite characters. I love Cameron. Cameron is my favorite. He's hilarious, like hilarious. And Sofia is one of my favorite characters as well.
Okay, thank you.
Teacher,
tell me.
It is an interesting topic about Sofia Vergara and her accent. What do you think about it? Some people say that her accent is a fundamental part or an elemental part of her interpretation.
Of her role.
Mm-hmm. What do you think about it?
I think it's true. I mean, I think her accent makes it funny in a way. And the thing is that they do make fun of it, but they also make fun of other things. So there are people that they say that, you know, like it's famous because of her fake accent, because it sounds really fake, because we don't talk like that. Because, I mean, I'm a Latino. I was born in Costa Rica, raised here, and I have never lived in the U.S., and I have never, ever gone to the U.S. So the thing is, like, I think it's funny, and I like that, again, that they make fun of everyone and everything. So they make fun of the perfect family that is Claire and Phil. They make fun of Sofia and her husband, and they make fun of everyone. So I think that it's not like they're just creating this stereotype of what a family is or what the Latin people actually look like or speak like. She definitely has a horrible accent, but again, it's part of the role that she has in the TV series. So I think it's cool. I really like Sofia, and her role in the TV series is fundamental. So fake, super fake. The accent is too fake. Like, we don't talk like that. But again, I think it's funny. What do you think, Ivan? Tell me.
Cool, teacher. I don't know. Maybe it is part of an stereotype. How do you say stereotype?
A stereotype.
A stereotype. And I am not sure about what to think about it, but even that, it is a good theory, I think. Teacher, yeah. I haven't watched that theory really, but some people say me that it is a good theory to learn English or practicate English because its vocabulary is simple and you can watch it without subtitles in Spanish. Do you recommend it?
Okay, the thing is this, yes, I recommend it, but there is one that I think would be more beneficial, which is, it's actually Netflix, because you have, this is not a commercial, again, Netflix is not paying anything for this, but there is one that is in Netflix that is called The Good Place. This one, The Good Place, I recommend it a little bit more, because the English that they have in throughout the TV series is like very proper and very easy to understand. So it's very, very easy to follow. But Modern Family, I mean, they have a lot of different pronunciations, but there are times when they speak faster than in other series. So I still recommend it. It's a great resource, it's funny. It's something they can relate to. It has modal. There's so many good things about it. So if you want to start watching it, yes, go for it. I do recommend it. But I also recommend this one that I wrote in the chat, The Good Place, which is in Netflix, because the one for The Good Place, their English, like, they go a little bit slower. So in my opinion, it's easier to understand. Just getting my teacher side one more time. I do recommend to watch it with subtitles, never in Spanish. Always in English. So in that case, you can actually see what they are saying and relate it with the subtitles. So you're like, oh, they said this and it is written this way. So that is my recommendation all the time. But yeah, it's a great TV series to watch it, because if you actually learn to like it, then you're gonna enjoy it, and you have 11 seasons to watch. So you're gonna have you're gonna spend a lot of time, let's say, studying, while at the same time you're having fun and watching something that you like. So yeah.
Thank you, teacher.
You're welcome. Yes.
But in general, for all the movies or series, do you recommend to watch in English with subtitles in English, or only the voice in English?
No. Always with subtitles. And again, the reason is that sometimes, I mean, English is a language that we are constantly learning. Even myself, sometimes I'm watching a TV series, and they say a word that I don't know. So if I see how it's written, then I can either imagine what the word means, or I can just go ahead and write it down and look it up. So even myself, after 10 years of speaking English, I would still go for subtitles. Like when I start watching TV, sometimes I forget to add the subtitles, I'm not gonna lie. But I mean, like, if I remember, or if I'm doing what it'd be, then watching that TV series like in my bed, paying attention to it, then in that case, I do recommend adding subtitles to it. It's a very good exercise, because you're training your mind, and you're also training your ear. So I do.
Teacher?
Thank you, teacher.
Tell me.
Teacher, have you seen Friends? What do you think about this series? Well, this series good Friends. To yes, it's good to learn English, or it's difficult to understand.
I'm gonna be honest about it. I have never watched Friends. I know what it is about. I know a lot of people love it and a lot of people recommend it, but honestly speaking, I don't think I have ever sit down and watch an entire episode of Friends, let alone watching a whole season or something like that. So I know people recommend it, but I cannot recommend it because I haven't actually watched it. Is it because, for example, for Modern Family, I have watched 10 seasons. So I know that, and I can talk about it. Or the same for The Good Place. I watch every single season for The Good Place. Or even this one, Emily in Paris. I think I just watched this one, which is very, very new. so I can talk about it. But for friends, I haven't, so I can actually tell you if it's great or if it's not so good. There are people that they're crazy about it and they love it, so I think the probably is good, but I cannot tell you for sure if it's a good resource or not.
Okay, teacher, I understand. And teacher, look this. Okay, I can understand some series, but other series I really can't understand anything. And maybe it's because how the actors talk. And maybe for example, I can understand friends and family and. What's the name? I forget the name, teacher, but like I say, okay, I can understand some series, but other series I really can't understand anything, and I think this is for the accent, or I don't know, the actors and maybe are speaking too fast.
That is perfectly fine, and thank you for mentioning that, Alan, because that is super common, guys. And so be aware that could actually happen. Sometimes you could find a TV series that you're watching and you're not understanding everything. This is so easy. And sometimes you can start watching a TV series and not understand a word. That is super super common. Again, it doesn't mean that you didn't have good English or that I don't know, like something else. Mostly, as Alan said, is because sometimes the actors or actresses, also the accent, or even the words that they're using. If they're using words that you're not familiar with, then how are you going to understand? Like, there's no way possible. It happened to me when the first season of Game of Thrones was released. I watched Game of Thrones, like all every single season. It's one of my favorite TV series as well. But it was without subtitles because I was a student back at university, because it was many years ago, and we were watching it on a not legal web page, so it didn't have like subtitles or anything, like in English or anything. So I remember that at the beginning with the first episodes, I struggled because it was in English, and I was like, it sounds super cool, but there's so many words that I don't understand, and like their accent is thicker because it sounds, I mean, supposedly it's kind of let's say British, rather than because British, but they do have like some accent. Some of the actors are British. So for that reason, I mean, it's more complicated to understand them. And again, by then I had already been learning English for what, at least 3 years or more. So by then I already spoke English and I was good at it. But again, since it was something completely new to me and there were so many words and the accent and so many things playing at one, it was difficult. So that is going to happen. That is very normal. Even when you talk to people, sometimes you might find people who you just don't understand, and that is perfectly normal. But for that reason is that we need to keep on listening to different things, watching different TV series, because that's for our ears to start expanding themselves, so we can actually then learn and kind of understand more things.
Okay, thank you, teacher, for saying that it's common, because now I'm feeling good for this.
Don't worry, my pleasure.
Thank you.
Okay, Danny.
I want to talk about Maze Runner. I like this movie.
It's amazing.
It's my, I felt my heart was beating a lot, sorry, for fear.
Excuse me, Dani. Have you seen the three movies?
Three movies? Yes.
Okay.
I see the two. Okay.
What is your favorite movie?
You can say trilogy.
Yes. My favorite movie is the first.
Wow. For me, it's the second.
So. I felt scary when they tried to escape from the maze. When
a spider
I don't know what is this. And the second movie in the desert is very scary for me because have zombies, I think, or the third movie, I don't remember.
Yes, was in the second movie.
Second movie have
yes.
Zombies. I very feel for the zombies. And this yes, this is my comment.
Well, for me the second part was the best, but I finished the movie and I was feeling very angry for the woman that because teacher, who I can say traidora?
Traitor.
Oh, teacher,
traitor.
Traitor, okay. The woman was a traitor, and for this, I finished the movie, and I was feeling very angry for this.
I forget to mention it. Dylan O'Brien is very handsome for me.
Yes. I think then you forget everything when you saw him.
Daniela, do you really like the drama of the movie?
Yes.
Obviously.
Yes, sure.
Obviously, for the drama.
The drama is very interesting. The more drama, more interesting.
No, Dylan O'Brien is the drama.
Yes, and more when they don't have share, no.
Oh my god.
Oh, teacher.
Yeah, tell me.
No.
Not teacher. Oh, sorry. I thought you were gonna ask a question because you said I heard is it teacher?
Yes.
Okay. Kenneth, do you want to say something?
Yes. Hi, guys. I didn't send you my list, but I can say someone. I think that I don't have favorite genre, but I have watched a little of all. I like The Walking Dead, Prison Break, Game of Thrones. Actually, I watching Ozark. It's about laundry money. The beginning, it's a little bored, but I try to continue. And about the movies, I don't remember my favorite, but the last week I went to watch Muerte en el Nilo, and it's really, really bad. The meaning of the movie, it's very common, and the scenes.
Yep, exactly, scenes.
Scenes are or look like fake because it's a very much addition or creation in computer. I don't know. And that's it.
Okay, thank you, Kenneth. Alina?
The other film I like is an animated movie. It's Coco. Because I love the culture Mexican with the people diet, because I believe that the people whose diet don't how do you say no se van del todo.
You can actually say like they don't leave.
Yeah, or his memories, it's in, or it's with us in uh-huh. in photos, in music, and because of the film lights, because this I believe that for example my father died in 2009 and I remember he with photos, music, and for me the film is beautiful.
Yes, this movie is very, very, teacher, how do you say, emotiva?
You can say emotive.
Okay, this movie is very emotive. And yeah, thanks, Alina. What, teacher?
No, the movie is beautiful, and I completely agree with Alina. Actually, it's fun because it doesn't matter how many times I watch the movie, I cry every single time because of the meaning it has. Because I do agree that people don't actually die until you forget about them. That if you keep on looking at their photos or videos, or if you keep on remembering them, like you actually, it's like if they were still with you. So. And it's fun because that's one of the things that I love about the Mexican culture, because I mean, I think, I don't know, maybe it's my perception, but I think that here in Costa Rica, sometimes we kind of, like when someone dies, of course, we're going to be sad because we're going to see the person like physically, but it's like we bury the person literally in, I don't know, like the memories as well. Like we try not to think about the person so we don't suffer. And my point is, it should be the opposite. It should be like, yeah, the person is no longer here, like you know, like the body, but we should like we have a stronger reason to actually think about the person and remember the person. So every time I have watched the movie like four times, I think or so, and every time that I watch it, the time when I'm gonna say this because I haven't watched it, but when close to the end when someone is gonna disappear. Like it gets to me, like it makes me cry a little bit because of the meaning that it has. I think I might pass to say something.
Yes. Hi. I tell other movie. The people know the people I don't know the movie the name is in English I don't know remember, but in Spanish the name Isla Siniestra. It's very interesting. The movie where the looking hospital, and then nothing it what it same. If the principal actor like actuar, how you say actuar, teacher?
Act, exactly.
The principal actor like act police, but it is very crazy. But how you say por eso?
Because of that?
Because Haidas is looking the hospital. The hospital is very interesting the long time. Como que te atrapa. How you say atrapar?
You can say that it catches your attention.
The caption in the movie is very interesting. Is the movie is all, but I recommend.
Andre, is that the one that is with Leonardo DiCaprio?
Yeah.
Oh, then in English, I think it's Shutter Island. It's amazing. That's the only thing I'm gonna say. If you haven't watched the movie, like, we cannot be friends. Like, you have to watch it like today, like after class, you have to go and watch it. No, I'm kidding. But I mean, it's really, yes, really good. I love the movie. It's amazing. It's one of my favorite movies. That one and the other one that is called Inception, which is the one that talks about dreams and how they get into a dream and then the dream of that dream. Oh my God, that is such a good movie. Like, yeah. I think I could watch it like every day and not and never get more of it. It's so good.
Excuse me, I don't remember the name in English because I was in the Spanish for job in the university for the medical. I don't remember. Creo que era cloridricina. For very interesting for me, I don't know. I como que yo no identificaba que era un sueño al final, hasta el final.
Oh, it's so good. It's such a good movie.
It's very interesting. I recommend for, I don't know, night, but I watch.
Teacher, about Leonardo DiCaprio, I was watching some months ago Leonardo DiCaprio movies, and when I began to watch this movie, how do you say it in English? La Isla Siniestra?
The Shutter Island, or Shutter Island.
Shutter Island, okay.
I think it's written like this. Let me go ahead and write in the chat.
Okay. I was very scared. I thought that it was a horror movie, and I hate horror movie. I'm sorry for that, but I can't sleep for months or for years
because of the movie.
It isn't a horror movie.
No, the woman is only a horror.
I was with a friend watching this movie, and I said, no, we have to change this movie, and I cannot watch that movie, but there are some people who say me that the movie actually is not an horror movie.
So, no, kind of suspense and a little bit of plot twist, because the end is the best. When you get to the end, it's just mind-blowing. It's so good. Like, you should watch it.
Okay. I swear, I'm going to watch the movie, but I have to to feel ready for that.
And Ivan, have you watched Inception?
Yeah, Inception. I love that movie. And I love one idea about that movie. The character, the Leonardo DiCaprio character, said that there isn't one thing more dangerous than an idea that you believe that you thought that. I don't know if I say it good, but this idea is powerful for me. And I played that idea in my job because I have to negotiate a lot of things in my job. And when you get you get that the people think for themselves, the idea that you have or you want to they think, it is very powerful for the relation and the negotiation, and that I love that movie.
It's really good. It's really, really good, and the message behind it is really good. I agree.
Well, in my case, I am a big fan. No, I am big Disney fan. You invite me to see the any Disney anime movie. I love her because, I love the Beauty and the Beast and Cinderella. Birdland is like Tierra de Osos. I love the princess. I am a child to 5 years, and I am sing to all songs to the princess, to the Encanto. I love Encanto. It's so cute, and I am crying.
Yes. It's such a nice movie.
It's a nice movie. I love the old movies to Disney. It's so magic.
Yeah, they are. The last movies is Disney is releasing, they're really good. Like Coco, I loved it. Encanto, I loved it. Yeah. One of these days, I watched, this one is super old, but I watched App. I never watched App, and I watched it, and it was so good. I was crying as well. I was like, it's funny because in the past, I would never cry for a movie, like never, ever. But I don't know, like I have watched these movies and I cried like a baby. I was crying so much. And I thought that I was just going to cry at the beginning when the old lady dies. But no, I cried like two or three times during the movie. And I was like, Jesus, I'm crying so much. Like, this is crazy. With Coco, I cried. And with Encanto, I didn't cry, but I loved the movie. I think it was really nice.
Yes, it's the magic of Disney. You cry all the time. I agree.
Richard, you haven't seen it up.
I hadn't. I mean, I hadn't, but I watched it like a month ago or so.
The Easter egg is very sad, and the grandpa is very angry because he don't have her. And I don't know, teacher, the history for me is very sad. Even every life is in love of her, and that is amazing. I don't know.
Yep.
In the parlor, the house is going to fly with balloons. It's so crazy. Like, whoa, the grandpa is a genius.
Yes, he's a genius.
You know, to pay the ticket and go to fly the place. I forget it. But it's a genius.
Can you remember the bird then they find in the island? Yeah, that bird is very crazy.
Yes. In the kid.
Yes, it was very funny.
Can I come with her?
Thank you, Lau.
Okay. Well, I didn't send my favorite movie or my favorite TV series, but I want to talk about my favorite movie is Memories of a Geisha. I have the book and I watched the movie a lot of times. It's about the history of a young Japanese woman who dedicates herself to entertaining and keeping men company, like maybe like seduction and by dancing, singing, serving tea or making a ceremony of tea. She dressed a traditional dress of Japanese. Also, she paint her face in white. And for me, I don't know, I think I am very boring because I really like all the movies and all the series like are old in old times, but that is my favorite. And my favorite TV series is, his name is Dexter. It's old too. Dexter is a serial killer that has a difficult past. When he was a child, he was when two killers killed her mom, and he have a lot of traumas. And when he was an adult, he killed like other killers. He kills only people that deserve to be killed. He used a method to select the people that he want to kill. Some fun fact about that TV series is that Dexter worked in police department, and they know how the killers thinks, and that's it.
Thank you, Lau.
Daniela?
I want to talk my favorite animations movie is from Studio Ghibli. I love this.
Chihiro.
Sorry?
The Trip of Chihiro. Or no?
Onion.
Ponyo. Okay, I love my neighbor Totoro. My favorite movie is Home Movie Castle. I have the book. I love this book from this movie. I love Ponyo. I love Memory of Marnie. I love all the movies from Studio Ghibli. It's very emotional for me. Sorry?
Have you seen the Chihiro Trip?
Yes. Chihiro. I forgot. Chihiro is my favorite. I love this movie.
Yes, for me it's the highlight of the movies of Ghibli City. And well, I haven't seen in some times this movie, but it's very confused. The Trip of Chihiro is very, very, very crazy. And well, when I go to see this movie, every time I find other meaning of the finish or other meaning of the things that are happening in the moment. But I don't know, for this movie, it's really, really special for me.
Yes, I need to see this movie a lot of times for understand, like you. It's very confused, but yes. It's very magical, fantastic.
Yes, it's very, very fantastic.
Yes.
Danny, do you see, I don't remember the name of English, the La Tumba de las Luciérnagas.
Yes.
Oh, it's very sad.
I cried with this movie. I cried a lot.
It's, so sad.
It's a sadder movie.
My top of Studio Ghibli movie is so amazing.
Amazing, yes. And sad.
But the final is sad. That's really, really sad.
Yeah, it's so sad, but it's my favorite movie.
Is it from Studio Ghibli?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Wow.
It's so sad.
I didn't know that. La Tumba de las Luciérnagas is so emotive.
Yes.
And if you know all the history about the Second World War,
yes,
you have about that.
I don't know, Ivan, but I think that this history was real, no?
Yeah.
Yes.
I don't know.
Nagasaki and Hiroshima.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
The family story in the movie, maybe it isn't the true story, but I'm sure that a lot of families in Japan,
yes,
leave things like that. And I have, or maybe we have to think a lot of things about that, because the Japanese government in the Second World War was incredible cruel. How do you say cruel, teacher? Cruel?
Cruel. I think it's cruel.
In Asia, and they conquest a lot of countries, China, and they attack to the US. They were Hitler in Asia, and then US lanzó la bomba. How do you say that?
The bomb.
The bomb.
We are not listening to.
Maybe we shoot the bomb.
Well,
hello, teacher.
This movie represents the pain of the family.
Yeah, yeah. The citizens who maybe never kill another people. And that's the problem, that a lot of people never wanted kill
experiment the pain
other
people.
Okay,
yes. It's for USA,
I don't know,
want to USA want to win the war with the bomb for Japan. US want to win the war.
I don't know, can you remember when the youngest guy in the movie and the little brother acabar?
He died?
Maybe for example, cuando se te acaba la comida.
Oh, when they run out of food.
Okay, when he got your candies and they didn't have food, that was very sad. And you can feel them.
Yeah.
Then they are feeling in the moment. That was very, very sad.
He ate.
I know with that kid is so sad.
He ate herbals.
Yes. Because every movie he saving your candies because they didn't have anything to eat when they spend when they spend everything they then have to survive, that's very sad. I don't know.
When the brother wants the balls of rice. His brother. It's so sad. I'm crying in this scene because the innocent the kid is so it represents the innocent kid. Yeah. So yes. The brother, he sentar? Sit down. The imagine rice bowl.
Yes.
It's so sad at this moment.
When I watched the Mi Vecino Totoro, I thought that maybe it was a similar final.
It's that?
A similar final because his mother was very sick.
Yes.
But
thanks God,
he never died. Yeah.
What is that? The sister gone to her see the mother and she left, but the big sister go to find her with Totoro. Mm-hmm. Yes.
I haven't seen Totoro. It's a good movie.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's a good movie. It's an emotional movie.
Studio Ghibli movie.
Sobrinos?
Nephew
or cousin, you need to see this movie with them.
Yes, I have a little nephew.
I see my brother and I said, you need to see that movie.
Yeah, well. We should to see the movie, guys.
Okay, thanks, Guy. Monse?
Thank you. I don't like my neighbor Totoro. I don't like. I don't know why, but I don't.
Dare you?
But Monse, do you like anime films?
So I see the movies Studio Ghibli. I like me, but I don't love them. I love this.
You view.
Well, but I like me. To make a films.
Excuse me.
Studio Ghibli is a must for to make a films. It's amazing. It's really amazing. It's another level.
I like the movies more bizarre or weird.
Maybe for example, have you seen the Hay que ser laberinto, teacher? Puzzle.
The Paulo.
Yes. That yeah. Movie. That movie is so good.
I saw, but I like this movie for the Civil War in Spain and the Maquis.
Yes. The movie is about this.
Is movie. I don't think Tarantino. I only one, but I don't finish it. I saw a picture, a movies of Cuerda is Spanish. Así en el cielo como en la tierra, and other Amanece que no es poco. This movie is favorite. It's my favorite. It's very weird, bizarre, absurda. What do you say, absurda? But
you can say bizarre.
Bizarre. All is al revés or weird. For example, I have a men's que what grown in the underground. So the woman or other people, riegan, what do you say? Water in the underground. No, underground, no, it's ground. And the man is bigger. And other movie is Tideland of ten. No, see, I don't remember the name, but is a picture about a child. She made the word fantasy in your head, and finally all is fantasy, and the reality is very, very pesada. What do you say, pesada?
In what sense?
Heavy.
Heavy. Yep. Uh-huh. It's very heavy. because the girl, the child is alone and your father is dead in that city alone. Your mother also is dead, and she is a child alone and crazy. What found in fantasy, your reality. With the fantasy, she survived. Your reality is very bizarre, but very, very good. Pueden verla, can you see? and enjoy.
Monse?
Yes?
Did you see Mama movie? Mama?
No, I saw, but I hate terror movies. I hate, I don't sleep. Same the Ivan, I don't, Stanley Kubrick. Yes, I see. I love Stanley Kubrick.
It's amazing. Stanley Kubrick is amazing. Have you seen The Shining?
The Shining. Uh-huh. I see. Hay otras que me gusta mucho. I don't remember.
The mechanic. The mechanic. Orange. Mm. Orange.
It's very.
That was a call.
Very bizarre.
Yes, but
the terror movie, I don't sleep. I hate the terror movies.
Well. Well, now that these movies are about of terror, and
okay. Thanks, Monse, Alan, Maria Paz, Danny, and now Alina.
Have you seen the movie Zelda 211?
No.
It's a Spanish movie. I recommend. It's about, how do you say, prison police. Policía carcelario.
I would say so. I didn't even know that they have a specific name. To me, they're all policemen.
Okay, police. He going to work in a prison, and when he visit that place, happen how do you say, motin?
Sorry, how do you say what?
Motin?
Motin?
Yeah.
Like,
in the prison?
Oh, like, well, it could be a riot, I think.
Okay.
Riot.
When he visit the prison, it happened a riot, and he doesn't wear a uniform, and other prisioneros, how do you say?
Prisoners.
Prisoners, seeing the man is other prisoner, and he, el que atrapado.
Oh, he's trapped.
Yes, yes. He's trapped in with other prisoners, and they think he is a prisoner, and is crazy. Es que how do you say? No quiero contar más porque estaría la película.
I don't want to say anymore.
I don't say anymore. I recommend it. Zelda 211. Zelda
211. Okay, okay.
It's a Spanish movie. It's a suspense or that was all.
Okay, thank you, Alina. Kenneth?
I didn't see any movies that you mentioned, but I remember one, Fragmental. It's an interesting movie. And more than the movie, I like the act of the principal actor because he interpret 24 personalities. And he did very, very, very well, in my opinion.
Yes, I see this movie.
Kenny?
Hola, hello.
Did you see Glass, the other?
Yeah. I saw, I don't remember the date, but yes, I did.
It's beautiful. Well, no, beautiful. No, it's very interesting movie.
Yeah, it was like beautiful. No, like that would be weird to say that it's beautiful.
Beautiful? No. Sorry.
What about this movie? Sounds interesting.
Interesting movie.
Yes.
Yeah. Interesting. I think that the better is the first one. The others, it's very well, but I like the first one.
It's about okay. Olvidé la palabra. Comic.
Ah, okay. Right?
Is that about comics?
I don't know.
I think I need to find.
Are you talking about different movies?
No.
Okay.
No. We are talking about Fragmental, no? Right?
Yes, please.
Yes.
Okay.
How can I say Fragmental in English, teacher?
Well, the thing is that would be fragmented. Mm. However, the name of the movie, is actually Split.
Split.
Yes.
Okay, thanks.
Split. Okay.
Okay, and thank you for your collaboration and participation. Okay. Now I am talk about Charlie Chaplin. One second, please. Okay. Charlie Spencer, or Charlie Chaplin, was born in London, England, United Kingdom, April 16, and 1889, and was British actor memorialist, composer, producer, screenwriter, director, writer, and editor. He acquired great popularity in silent cinema thanks to the multiple films he made with his character Charlotte, and he is considered a symbol of humor and silent cinema. And towards the end of the First World War, he was one of the most recognized men in the world and cinematography. Anyone saw any movie about Charlie Chaplin?
I can say prayer teacher, lunch.
Laugh,
okay. Well, I think that Charlie Chaplin was a genius because can love people when you don't talk anything or don't say any word. It's very, very, very hard. And for this, I think that Charlie Chaplin was a genius of humor.
Yes, and now he died, but it's a symbol of the cinematography world.
I haven't watched any movie, any Charlie Chaplin movie, but I have watched a lot of movies of Mr. Bean.
It's very same. Well.
And I think that he is a little similar to Charlie Chaplin because
the black and white.
He makes you laugh without words or without a lot of sound, and he's very good. But Charlie Chaplin is like the actor. It's like the how do you say comediante?
Comedian.
He's the humorist. The main humorist in the history of the cinema.
Yes, but I agree to you, bro.
I like Mr. Bean. Excuse me, Alan.
Okay, I agree to you, bro. You should to see Charlie Chaplin. It's very funny.
Yes, okay.
I knew only one scene in the bus from Charlie Chaplin in the playlist occasion. Only one scene. I very bored to view the same scene in the bus from Los Chiles or Santa Rosa.
It's a classic. It's a classic. Yes. A tiger, a Bosa. Tiger in the.
Yes.
Okay, entering. I'm going to see Charlie Chaplin.
I didn't understand if Daniela likes Charlie Chaplin.
No, she thinks that Charlie Chaplin is bored.
No, I bored of the same scene.
Okay.
Did you like Charlie Chaplin?
Continue, Ivan.
Daniela, did you like?
I don't know. I only So I only seen one thing. I think I like.
Okay, cool. I'm going to watch Charlie Chaplin movies.
Good choice, good choice.
Can? Yes, me too.
I saw someone's videos about Charlie Chaplin because I take in the university a course of cinema workshop teacher, taller de cine.
Yeah. Cinema.
Okay. Cinema workshop. And the teacher put the videos about him. The teacher said something like, we should learn to I don't remember, but él decía algo como que tenía que aprender a... Es que no me acuerdo. A ver, pero... But the meaning of that I said, it's interpret the meaning of the productions, and that Alexa, is
that is. ¿En qué año nació Charlie Chaplin?
Charlie Chaplin when nació el 16 de abril de 1889.
So that is very interesting because that Alan said he doing or he says very much sin decir nada pues.
Yes. Kenneth, it's tiempos modernos.
I don't remember the name that I saw, but
he works in fabrica. How do you say fabrica?
Factory.
In a factory, he's coloca tornillos.
He places screws.
He places screws. Yes, I recommend Ivan. Tiempos modernos.
Nice. Thank you, Alina.
Okay, guys. In the next activity, I am going to talk about to the first film. This is how the first film movie in history was filmed on project. The Lumiere brothers market a milestone into the history of humanity. They were two ones who made and screened the first film in 1895. They filmed it in Paris on March 19. And baptized is Les Sorties du Vieux du Cinéma Lumière à Lyon. The departure of the worker from the Lumiere factory in Lyon. And this is the first film. Teacher, you see the video?
I can see it, but I cannot hear it.
This video don't have a audio.
Yeah, sound. Okay.
Okay, now let's see some of the film handwriting. Okay, one second. Okay. Film handwriting, and you took a big try. Okay, one second. First trailer is one video, one second, please. Yeah, with problems. Okay, it's an action trailer.
Let's go for a little ride.
This is yours, but if you win, you get hurt.
Okay, we don't have a lot of time, so now I put a video trailer of adventure. Second, I have controls.
This is a fun group. Welcome to detention. Spencer, Bethany, Fridge, Martha. You're all here for a reason.
Hey, person walking!
You should be thinking about who you are and who you want to be. You'll have plenty of time to figure that out while you're cleaning out the basement.
Are you gonna help or are you too pretty?
I'm too pretty.
Yo, what's this?
A game for those who seek to find a way to leave their world behind. Jumanji. Pick a character, and you're that person in the game.
Which one do I pick?
I don't think it matters that much.
Zeus Finbar. Sounds like a badass.
I'll be the curvy genius.
Dr. Smolder Bravestone.
I guess I'm Ruby Roundhouse.
Where's the rest of me?
Oh my God, Fridge?
Yeah, I'm Fridge. Who are you?
It's me, Spencer.
Who is she?
Martha?
Why am I wearing half a shirt and short shorts in the jungle?
I think we got sucked into Jumanji and we've become the avatars we chose.
So that means...
Bethany?
Oh, wait, Bethany, don't look at it!
I'm an overweight middle-aged man.
Oh. I don't have my Claritin, and all I see around here is pollen.
Well, I don't have the top 2 feet of my body.
Damn, that is a man right there. Don't cry, don't cry. Don't cry, it's gonna be okay. Welcome
to the jungle. This is a video game, which means we all have special skills.
Why am I running so slow?
That was so intense. I like can't even with this place.
Watch your step in here.
Maybe we're all in a coma.
What?
That old game machine must have electrocuted us and now we're all...
Oh my God! You better get in there and save her.
I'm not gonna get in there.
You get in there. I got a backpack on. You don't get in water with a backpack. Everybody knows that.
Oh, Okay, and let's see. This is a science fiction trailer.
Refer to the prophecy of the one who will bring balance to the Force. You believe it's this boy?
He can see things before they happen.
He can help you.
The Force is unusually strong with him.
He was meant to help you.
Anakin! Tell him to take off!
Will I ever see you again?
What does your heart tell you?
Are you sure about this? Trusting our fate to a boy we hardly know?
Anakin Skywalker, meet Obi-Wan Kenobi.
I sense much fear in you.
The boy is dangerous. They all sense it. Why can't you?
Fear is the path to the dark side. Fear leads to anger. Anger leads to hate. Hate leads to suffering.
Okay, and now I am comedy Henry.
'78, they were the best of friends.
Everybody say championship.
Now they're getting back together for the first time in over 30 years.
Iggy! Hey, what's up, Lenny? Buddy, I thought you were gonna start working out.
What does that mean?
You're fat?
No!
Next summer, they're meeting each other's families.
Oh, and this must be your mother.
My wife.
I'm sorry.
I'm not. Oh, grody.
Learning about their kids.
Mommy, I want some milk.
Come here. Give me a little something.
Your son is so cute. How old is he?
48 months. That's four. Yeah.
And reliving their past.
Rope on a tree, baby. Class is in session.
Oh, baby.
That's
wrong.
That's wrong.
This was a mistake. Let go. I can't let go. I'm so scared.
Sandler, Kevin James, Chris Rock, Rob Schneider, and David Spade. Grown-ups.
Okay, this is a bit trailer about the documentary, and it's the end of the trailers.
My name's Nicole, and I'm calling because I'm concerned about a friend of mine. I dropped her off at her house at 2 a.m. last night, and I haven't been able to get a hold of her this morning. I've gone to her house, and her car is there. She won't answer phone calls. She won't answer text messages.
What's her name?
Shanann Watts.
Hey, guys. My name is Shanann. I just want you to know a little bit of my story. I went through one of the darkest times of my life, and then I met Chris. And he's the best thing that has ever happened to me.
How are you doing?
How's it going?
There was no note or anything?
No.
I don't know what to do right now.
I've done everything in my heart to make my family's life better.
Don't eat turtle!
I think about, like, did I cause this? Did I make her feel like she needs to leave?
She said things were bad and that she didn't know what was going on with Chris.
I'm worried sick. This is completely unlike her.
My mom just never thought she was good enough.
Do you have any idea if he thought his wife had a boyfriend?
Maybe she sat there and thought about it. Do I really need to stay here right now? Like, if he doesn't love me, maybe I should just go.
Did she accuse you of anything?
I tortured him. I rejected him.
Did you cause Shanann's disappearance?
We're not promised tomorrow. We're not promised anything.
There's only one person in this room that knows what the truth is. And in about 5 minutes, there's going to be two of us.
Okay, I have more trailers of different genres, but we don't have a lot of time. So I think until now, do you want a trailer of a specific genre to finish? Or, I don't know. ¿Alguno de estos? O seguimos con la presentación. Alejandro. It's the same I've seen though, from the bulls.
Really?
Yes.
I can't believe it.
One question, Daniela, about that. The film that you watched has piano music? Or it was mute, like this?
Mute.
Okay.
Like this.
Okay, guys, this is a gender by format, and the others gender by format are sound cinema, 2D, 3D, animation, and these are some of genders according to setting. Number one, religious, 2, futurist, 3, police, 4, crime, 5, warlike, number 6, history, number 7, sports, and number 8, western.
Alejandro?
Yes?
What is the meaning of warlike?
Warlike is a movies or war.
Okay.
Or yes, it's a movie or war.
What is the meaning of western?
Western is a old west.
Like cowboys.
Yes, the cowboys.
Like Back to the Future 3. Those are...
Okay, guys, this is the most, this is a graphic for the most loved movie genders by fans. Number one is suspense, have a 29%. Number two, drama, have a 29%. Number three, comedy, have a 21%. Science fiction is number four. Half a 14%. And the last is action, half a 7%.
Guys, we have a 3D for you, but we don't know if we have time, teacher.
How much time do you think that you actually need for the activity?
What?
How much time do you think that you have, that you need for the activity?
I don't know if, I don't know what is the number of questions or this activity. In this activity is where we have a problem later.
Teacher, 20 minutes approximately.
No, then I think it's better if we actually stop here, because I did want you guys to, well, we're not gonna have impromptu today because of the time, but I do want you to practice impromptu so you can get an idea what impromptu speech is. So I think maybe it's better if we stop here, so we can have a little bit of practice for impromptu, and then we can go ahead and leave.
Okay. Okay. And thanks for your attention, classmates and teacher. And thanks for your participation and collaboration.
Thank you. Okay, guys, so again, now let's go ahead and talk about business. Let's talk about impromptu speech. In this case, do you remember what impromptu speech is?
No, teacher, can you remember us?
Sure, I can remind you what it is about. Impromptu speech is just gonna be a type of a speech that you create all of a sudden. So how does it work? For example, we're gonna have a roulette, which I have ready already. And you're going to, I'm going to select the person, let's say Ivan. And I'm gonna say, okay, Ivan, it's your turn. So I'm gonna show the roulette. We're gonna spin the roulette and we have several topics on the roulette. Actually, I think we can go ahead and present the roulette. Let me go ahead and, okay, so how in here. Okay, let me go ahead and share my screen so you can actually see what it is about. Okay, by now you should be able to see my screen. Do you see it? Okay, so this one, for example, is like that. I'm going to give you a specific topic and then, well, kind of. So let's say Ivan. So I say, Ivan, you're next. And then we go ahead and we spin the roulette. And what you're gonna be doing is that you're going to talk about the topic that you have over there. In this case, it's going to be education. So Ivan has to talk about education for 6 minutes, at least non-stop, okay? Again, I'm not gonna limit this to a specific type of conversation to take. Ivan can talk about what he thinks about education. Maybe he can even go back and tell us about any anecdotes that he had when he was in high school or school, or even at the university level. He can even go ahead and, Ivan, you're from Venezuela, I think, right?
No, Nicaragua.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, in that case, Ivan can tell us about, for example, how is the educational system in Nicaragua, in case that he knows, etc., whatever. So he can go pretty much and talk about anything that has to do for education. The idea here is that he doesn't stop, that he keeps on talking for that specific time, okay? Of course, today what we're gonna be doing real quick, just a few of us will be for a few minutes and it's not gonna be graded. However, the one that we'll have on Thursday, that one will be graded. So, and that one is worth 15% of your final grade, okay? So it's nothing to worry about, but it is, it requires your attention on it, okay? So again, this one is just practice. So I'm gonna see if I have any volunteers to actually try to do it.
Teacher?
Yes.
Excuse me. This week is that activity.
Yes, it was gonna be half today and half on Thursday. But in this case, since the speaking session was actually, it got a little bit after time, even though it was for a really meaningful conversation, which is okay. Since we're not gonna have time for that, so what we're gonna be doing is practicing a little bit. And then Thursday, we're going to have the impromptu speech for most of the people.
Okay, teacher, and we have a rubric for this?
Rubric. Yes, we do have a rubric for this.
Okay. It is in the syllabus.
No, the rubric is not in the syllabus. I have it with me. Actually, I can go ahead and show it to you. Let me go ahead and share my screen so I can actually show you the rubric. Just a second.
Okay. Then I want to try, please.
To try.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I love that.
Okay, let me go ahead and show
the rubric first. Sorry again. Oh no, it's not this one.
Teacher?
Yes, tell me.
Me too, if you can, or if you or we have time to do.
Yeah, of course. Okay, there you go. Now you can see the screen. This is the rubric that I created for this. So time, length, and message. So for example, if you go ahead and the speech lasted time, the set, last time set, allowing the speaker to portray a clear and precise message, then you get the 20 points. If it is a speech lasted less than less time than the one was said, but it does not affect the message, you still get 15, so on and so forth. Also, we're gonna talk about confidence, like when you're speaking, do you sound confident? Like, do you like, I don't know, like, you know, when people are speaking and they, like, their voice breaks because they're very nervous, then it goes like that. Then, of course, pronunciation, which is a key part of this, grammar usage, of course. We have covered so many different structures by now. You know how to use past, how to use present, how to use present perfect, simple past, progressive. There's so many structures that you have already learned how to use. So I'm actually hoping, or not hoping, expecting you to use more than one of those. Hesitation is also very important. Sometimes people do a lot of hesitation. I don't know if you know what hesitation is, but hesitation is that, that is hesitation. When you are like, when you're not speaking, you're just like making these sounds, which maybe is because you're nervous or you don't know what to say, or because you're actually just wasting time because you're like, oh, 6 minutes, I'm gonna spend 3 minutes, you're like, and then say something, and it goes like that. So that is also going to affect your presentation or your grade, not your presentation, but your presentation, and therefore your grade. Yeah, tell me. I think Sam had her end race. Go, Sam.
The one who has to speak is only Ivan.
No, today we're going to have volunteers. I mean, today anyone can do it. We can have around maybe 3 or 4 volunteers. So you can actually have an idea of what it is. You can, the ones that are going to do it today, they can try it, like, you know, experience what it is about. And then their rest can actually take a look at what it is and how difficult it is. And on Thursday, everyone is going to do the real one. Today is just practice. So if you actually want to practice, it's okay.
Teacher, okay. And the topics for Thursday, that's the same that you have in the rule.
Or you in the rule that, they might change. I'm not saying they will be the same. They might be the same or they might not be the same. So I was thinking to have one with historical events. Maybe World War II, the Cold War, then the Holocaust. I was thinking to have one like those. Okay, so Ivan, ready?
Teacher.
Tell me.
Let's go.
Excuse me, I have a question. What's happening if I am doing my speech and I don't remember the how to say one word in English? We can ask you, or it's not allowed?
No, that's such a good question. Thank you, Lau. No, you're not allowed to ask me, because the idea is for this to be impromptu. So if you start asking me and asking me and asking me, we could be wasting a lot of time. So the idea is that you actually use your skills to actually paraphrase. So if you want to say, I don't know, car, and you don't know how to say car, then you can go ahead and say, oh, this vehicle that you use to move from one place to the other, blah, 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 or something like that. The idea is to actually, let's say, put you in a situation that is going to generate a stress to your brain, so you can find a way to unstress and be able to talk. And again, as I told you last time, this is not done to make you suffer, not quite the opposite. This is done because when you are under, let's say, the stress, this type of situation, which could be seen as a stressful, people sometimes, they just, they close up, but they have, for this, they have to open up so they can actually go ahead and talk or create sentences. So it is like, how can I say, it's like forcing your brain to open up under a stressful situation and actually think. So it's a really good exercise. I know that at first, of course, it sounds like something horrible, because I know that it sounds scary. But I mean, for example, I have done this so many times in my classes. And once I had a student, like, after I taught her, and she told me that something like this happened to her at work, that she was asked to talk about a random topic. And she told me, I remember the impromptu speech. And she told me, like, it was very useful because I didn't panic. And I felt more at ease when I had to speak. So that's the reason why I keep on doing it, because I have seen that it's actually pretty useful. And it also shows me how good you are at using the language. Because again, a grammar quiz shows how good you are, but this one is what shows how good you are speaking. And here, the main focus for us teachers is speaking. So that's why I actually do it. Okay, anyway, anymore without Anyway, without any more talking, let's go ahead and start with our first victim. No, I'm kidding, with the first contestant of the day. Ivan, you ready?
Yeah, teacher.
Okay, let's see which is going to be your topic.
No.
Cooking.
Okay,
Ivan, you have, let me go ahead and set a timer real quick.
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to have a timer. This one is just going to be for 4 minutes because I know this one is going to be just practice. On Thursday is going to be 6. Okay, I don't know if you can see it. There you have 4 minutes starting. So go, Ivan.
Okay, teacher. I'm going to talk about how I learned to cook a little bit of dishes with my grandmother, with my mother, and with my dad. Okay. I have lived alone since 1 year ago, so I have to cook even if I don't like it, because I have to survive. So I have to practice the cooking lessons that my grandmother gives me or taught me when I was a child. And sometimes I have to call to my grandmother to ask her about some dishes. In my day by day, I cook kitchen, I cook fish, I cook rice and beans, I cook pancakes, and like you see, these are all simple dishes, but I have to do particular things to make it nice. So my grandmother told me that I have to prepare the kitchen before cook it. I have to prepare it with some vegetables. For example, the night before I cook kitchen, I have to wash the chicken. Chicken, I have to wash the chicken, and I have to put it in a cup, and I have to add in sauce and vegetables, and then I have to put it in the refrigerator, and the chicken has to stay like that for some hours before that I cook it. Okay, this is a lesson from my grandmother, and I learned to make pancakes with my mother when I was a child, and it is a very simple thing. I buy the time it's over.
Yes, time's up.
Okay.
Okay, that was actually really good. I might even do it really good. Though again, those were just 4 minutes. On Thursday's gonna be 6. So just for you to know. But how do you feel? Easy.
I have to, how do you say improvisar?
Improvise?
Yeah. And
but that's the whole point of it. This one is like if you, how much knowledge you have, how much vocabulary you have, how many sentences you can make, how many tenses you can, you know, like dive into, etc. So many different things. Thank you, Ivan. Do I have any other volunteer? Who else wants to try?
Do you have feedback for me, teacher? Excuse me.
There were a few things that were mispronounced or so, but I think overall was actually really good. Like if this was the one that was graded, most likely you'd be getting a good grade. Super quick, a word that you're mispronouncing a lot, vegetables. That one you're pronouncing it a lot, but overall actually I think it was really good.
Okay, thank you.
I like that you didn't have any hesitation, that you kept on talking. So maybe you were not going the fastest, but you didn't stop. Like you were like, so my grandma taught me how to. So I think that was a really cool pace. We could understand what you were saying. We could follow your story. And at the same time, you were not giving me a lot of hesitation. So again, that was a really great example. So thank you, Ivan.
Thank you, teacher.
Guys, any other volunteers? Alan, you raised your hand. You want to be a volunteer or you have a question?
No, if nobody wants to try, and I'm going to try.
Okay, I love that. Thank you. That's the attitude that we need. Okay, so ready?
Yes.
Okay, let's see which is going to be your topic. Okay, your topic is going to be sleep. Okay, Alan, you ready?
Yes.
Okay, there you can see that it's 4 minutes and that it's counting down. So go ahead.
Okay, well, that topic maybe can be hard for to explain a lot of time because sleep is, a specific thing. And well, but what I think of sleep, well, I think that the people need show sleep good for to have a good life and vital life, because sleep is important for to be a restless people, or maybe I can say for to be a person very worked, for to be a hard worker person, and for this sleep it's very, very important. And well, I know a thing of sleep, and as sleep is important, and you maybe have maybe you should have 8 hours of sleep for day, because your brain and your body and everything of you need sleep for to recover your energies and recover your your energy for to every time feel good and be a person that can be hard worker. Well, maybe I don't sleep a little time, and maybe I sleep around 4 or 6 hours a day, because every time I'm doing a lot of things, maybe to study or trying or I don't know. And every time I doing a lot of things and like a desk. Well, and for this I sleep I don't sleep a lot of time. Well, in my personal case, for don't sleep a lot of time, every time I can feel tired, and that isn't a good thing, because when I can do, when I went do other thing, then it's out of my my normal things, then I do in my normal days. Well, I can be feel tired for this, and well, for this I think that the persons show sleep good for to feel good, for to do great the things then I show to do. Well, other thing of sleep, and then I know it's maybe when you do a lot of exercise or a lot of your jobs, you need a sleep and maybe 8 hours or 10 hours for to recover your muscles or your brain, and that is the best thing that you can do, because you can be sure of if you sleep more time, you can be a better person in your normal activities than you do every day.
Thank you. Time's up. That was actually really good, Alan. Just be careful with the format, subject verb agreement or subject verb complement, because in also grammar, those are my two main comments for you. Be careful with those, because in some cases you were not using the proper structures, or you were kind of mixing them or something like that, in a way that, for example, you were telling me like I've been, for example, nor I have been, or I have, or I am, I don't know, cooking or something. Just be careful with grammar. And that's pretty much it. It was actually pretty good.
Okay, teacher, one tip to improve?
Again, something that I always recommend is like to do something like this, like for you, go on the web and then just think about a topic, for example, something that you like, any topic, maybe movies, and grab your phone and start recording slowly, so then you can actually listen to yourself and start speaking about the topic. For example, I don't know, movies. My favorite movie is Inception. I have watched this movie like 20 times. What I like the most about the movie is that it talks about dreams and how one can get into somebody else's dream, and then inside that dream you can get into another dream, etc. To start talking about the topic that you like, and then to listen to yourself and pay attention, not listen to see what you actually said, but listen like if you were a teacher and start looking for sentences. Oh, this the teacher or the person said, I am, or what I like the most, is this grammatically correct? Let me analyze. Or the teacher said, he has watched. Okay, is that grammatically correct? Yes. What type of tense is this? Is it a present perfect tense? Is it a past perfect tense? What type of tense? So start looking for that. And something super common that happens to us Costa Ricans, and I think I have mentioned this, I don't remember if I have, is that we have in Spanish something that we call sujeto tácito, which is the one that is not present in the sentence, but we do know it, even though we don't say it. Is that when we say, for example, voy para el super. So we know that that voy means like I am going to the supermarket. But in English, we do it, and in English, it doesn't exist. So in English, you can never forget about the subject, never. You have to bring it on, you have to have it there. So you cannot say going to the supermarket, no. I am going to the supermarket, or I'm going to the supermarket. I'm going to the supermarket. That would be incorrect. You need to give me always a subject, a verb, and a complement. Well, in most of the cases.
Okay, teacher. Okay, your tip is improve my grammar tenses.
Exactly. Look at tenses and look at your grammar. That's pretty much the tip that I would give you. In timing, there was pretty much no hesitation, so I think it was really good. And of course, always that something that can always be a tip is look for vocabulary. Think about things that you want to say, and if you don't know how to say something, write the word. I don't know, how do you say dilemma? How do you say, I don't know, ballena? How do you say, and then if you don't know how to say it, then look for the word, and then you can incorporate it into your vocabulary. Oh, ballena is whale, so I love whales. Oh, which is the word that I said? Oh, I forgot, anyway. So that's what you can do, and that's going to help you increase your vocabulary. And the more vocabulary you have, if you match your vocabulary with your grammar, then you can have beautiful English. So, and of course,
thank you, teacher.
You're welcome. Always keep in mind, very important, guys, for the impromptu speech, I need you to activate your cameras for the ones that will be speaking at the moment. And very important, make sure that when, because I have said this before, when we're speaking English, or in Spanish, sometimes we don't open our mouth a lot, but we keep it very close. No, in English, you have to open your mouth so actually we can hear the different sounds, the different, how you pronounce things on a different way, so on and so forth. So keep that in mind. Any other volunteer?
Teacher?
Tell me.
We have a homework.
For Thursday?
Yes.
No, on Thursday, what we're going to try to do is to check the homework that I gave you last week, but not the one. Today, I'm not going to give you any homework.
Okay, in the last week?
Uh-huh.
No. Okay, yes.
Okay, guys, any other volunteers?
Teacher, ¿usted se puede quedar un momento al final conmigo, porfa, para aclarar una duda?
I think so. Guys, any other volunteer? Nope. Okay. Then, lo bueno es que no le di chance de practicar, ¿verdad? Porque this was your trial. This was your trial.
Me again.
Me again. It's okay. Don't worry. I mean, you're going to do great. Okay, for the rest, now you know how it works. I recommend you, if you don't want to do it here because I don't know, you will be ashamed or something, do it at home. You could do it right now after you finish. You could just go ahead and try to listen. Like grab your phone and choose any of the topics, let's say beauty or love, or one that you're not familiar with. Because remember, on Thursday you could get any topic. It could be a topic that you really like, I don't know, maybe movies, or it could be a topic that you hate, maybe money, cooking, shopping, extra books. What are you going to say about it? So I think you should pick the ones that are the most difficult for you and try to talk about those. I mean, of course, on your own, and then try to see how difficult it was for you. Because again, on Thursday is going to be for 6 minutes. So it's important that you actually practice on that. Anyway, if we have no more volunteers, I'm not going to stop you any longer. I'm going to let you go and have an amazing night. So take care, guys. Tell me.
Excuse me. Can you send me these topics for practice, please? And one question. Are we going to check the homework this Thursday also?
I hope so. I mean, it depends on how much time we have, because again, I want everyone to present, or most of you to present. So if we have time to check your homework, then yes.
Okay, thanks, teacher.
You're most welcome. Okay, guys, take care and see you on Thursday. Study, but study, practice a lot, because this one is gonna be mostly for you to practice. So practice a lot and see you on Thursday.